Hey, Prairie Hiders, happy 4th of July. No matter where you are watching from, I'm so thankful that we are able to experience Jesus together today in this specific way. I've got a quick message for you, followed by a challenge for the whole day. That's right. There's going to be a challenge for you and all the people that you're hanging out with for the rest of the day. We're calling it a 4th of July weekend Prairie Heights family challenge for all of us. We've been in a series called Family Vacation. We've been leaning in and learning how to live a Jesus-centered life and create environments in our home and in our community where we model what that looks like. So today, we're going to be challenged to model and to live out the message. And I'm so excited for how God will use this message and this time together to serve and love others throughout your day. On Independence Day in the United States, we recognize our country's freedom. What I want to dig into today is how does God intend for us to experience freedom in our lives? So the first way that we're going to find out how is in Galatians chapter 5, it's verses 13 through 14. All right, so Galatians chapter 5, verses 13 and 14, it says, "You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free, but do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh. Rather, serve one another humbly in love. For the entire law is fulfilled in keeping this one command, love your neighbor as yourself." I'm going to say that last part one more time. In keeping this one command, love your neighbor as yourself. So our first point, freedom is loving others as yourself. Did you get that? Freedom, when we live like God, when we live like Christ, freedom is loving others as yourself. The second one that we're going to dive into comes from Romans 6, 6 through 7. In Romans chapter 6, verses 6 and 7, it says, "For we know that our old self was crucified with him." Our old self was crucified with Jesus. "So that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin." Anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Our second point, freedom is being set free from sin. Freedom is being set free from sin. I want to share a story with you about a Grammy Award-winning artist, and his name is Zach Williams. And he never thought his purpose would include prison ministry, but as God often does, right, in many of our lives, God had a different plan for Zach. And after Zach had a God moment at a prison, he felt like God was really confirming the call that he had on his life. And Zach shares this exact moment. He kind of shares, "I felt like God was saying to me that this is what I have for you. This is what I want you to do. This is who I want you to write for. These are the places I want you to be." And then it was years later, Zach wanted to record music at Harding Prison in Nashville. And he said this, "To be honest, I remember the day I got there." And he was thinking, "What have I gotten myself into? I have no idea what I'm going to say to these guys." And he remembers one of the guards had told him, "You know, these guys, if they think for a second that you're fake, game over." And so Zach shared how God prepared him for that moment, and how over the course of 6 hours from the hopelessness that many of these men faced, that all of a sudden they were choosing hope that day in Jesus. And Zach shares, "I watched several of those men find freedom behind bars." Did you get that? He says, "I watched several of those men find freedom behind bars." That's our third point. Freedom is knowing whose family you belong to first. Freedom is knowing that you belong to God, that you belong to God's family first, that your identity is in who God says that you are a child of God first. And no matter what our circumstances are, when you and I can live with that confidence, with that freedom in Christ, knowing whose we are, that we belong to Jesus, it's amazing, right? Then we can have freedom to love others more than ourselves. We can have the freedom to be set free from our sin. And so today, I challenge all of us. I want to challenge us to continue this on throughout our day. And so the first way that I want to challenge you is I want you to listen to that song by Zach Williams that he recorded at Harding Prison. The song is called No Longer Slaves. You can find it on YouTube. And you can simply search No Longer Slaves by Zach Williams. It was at Harding Prison. I want you to listen to that with your friends, with your family, with your kids. If you're hanging out on your own right now, I want you to share that song with a friend. Go ahead and share that over a message. And as you listen to the lyrics, I want you to think about the freedom that you find in being a child of God, the freedom in knowing whose family you belong to first. The second thing that I want you to do is I want you to read, and I know this is a challenge, and begin to memorize Galatians 5, 13 and 14, those two verses. And I want you to take turns memorizing the verses throughout the day. And at the end of the day today, I want you to gather one more time with the people you're with. And I want you guys to see how far that everyone came to fully memorizing those two verses. You can do it. I know you can. And then the next thing I want you to do is I want you to pick someone to serve. To serve really humbly in love today. Make it a competition, or as a group, pick a specific way to love someone really well. Just a couple really simple ideas. Maybe you have a really large family. You can put all your names in a bucket. Everyone picks a name, and the person's name that you get, you've just got to love them and intentionally love them today over yourself. I know, sometimes that's hard to do. Or maybe you're going out to eat, or you're going over to another friend's place, and I want you to think about on your way over, how can you serve and bless them in a memorable way today? Because remember, freedom is loving others as yourself. Freedom is loving others as yourself, as you would want to be treated, as you would want to be blessed. It's loving others that way. And then lastly, as you go to bed tonight, I want you to reread Romans 6, 6 and 7. And I want you to know that when you genuinely ask for forgiveness from your sins, you are forgiven. You are forgiven. So don't hold on to any more shame, guilt, or past sin. Before your head hits the pillow tonight, I want you to find a quiet space to ask God for forgiveness in your life. Because that's how you're going to experience freedom. Knowing that freedom is being set free from sin. And as you and I, as we recognize our nation's freedom today, let's take moments throughout the day to experience freedom with Jesus. I love you all so much. I hope you have a happy and safe 4th of July. Can't wait to see you next Sunday.